Okay, Your Excellency, ladies and gentlemen, allow me at the outset to express our profound appreciation for the organizers of this event, for having invited us to share with them the celebrations of historic events in Sudan, i.e., the closing stage of the 2005 CPN event, the election, and the successful Sudan referendum on the March of January 2011. Indeed, the referendum in Sudan was monitored by the entire international community, which expressed dissatisfaction and described the process as credible, free, fair, and transparent. On the 7th of February 2011, the final results of the referendum were announced. Sudanese president issued the same day a presidential decree endorsing the results of the referendum. As these results for him represents the free will of the southern people. Not only did he endorse the result of the referendum, but he also expressed the commitment of the government of the Sudan as to be the fairest, to recognize, as from the 9th of July 2011, the newly born state in South Sudan. He also pledged to render all possible technical and logistical assistance to the independent South Sudan. As the post-referendum contentions outstanding issues, the president said they were resolved to reach an agreement on them before the end of the transitional period, i.e. before the 9th of July 2011. On his part, Vice President and Chairman of the Government of Southern Sudan, Salva Kiir, lauded the North's recognition of the new state, saying it would pave the way for other countries to follow suit. I quote, "If the North does not recognize the South, no other state will do," he said. Salva Kiir said that the secession of the South is not the end of the road. We will not become enemies of each other, and we will make sure our relationship remains strong, he said. He added that the border between the North and the South would only be on papers, and there would be no restrictions on the movement of trade and citizens. Northerners and Southerners officials must also agree on other sensitive issues such as the Nile water, security, border disputes, national assets, foreign debts, and especially citizenship. Both parties must agree on the status of thousands of Southerners living in the North and vice versa. President al-Bashir had assured that the Sudanese South settled in the North will be protected and their property will not be confiscated or their life threatened. The historic event in Sudan will usher in a new chapter in the future relations between the North and the South as from the 9th of July 2011. It's the date of the official proclamation of the independence of a new state in South Sudan, which will be the 54th state African state. I also would like to use this opportunity to convey the appreciation of the authorities in Sudan for the outstanding contribution Canada has been extending to assist all parts in Sudan to fully implement the CPA. We also would like to express our satisfaction vis-a-vis the statement issued by the Right Honorable Stephen Harper, Prime Minister of Canada, on the results of the referendum in Sudan, with special emphasis on his pledge to assist both parties themselves in Sudan in charting their post-referendum future. The government of Sudan calls upon the international community, including Canada, to assist South Sudan in the post-war reconstruction. North Sudan will spare no effort to see to it that a strong prosperous, stable, and vibrant state be established in the South Sudan. Sudan will be the more prosperous and vibrant South Sudan will be, the more sustainable and comprehensive peace will be prevailing in the whole Sudan, and the less, and the people will no more have any fears vis-a-vis the reigniting of the conflict. Indeed, the two countries have no alternative but to maintain their cooperation and to expose a policy of good neighborliness. Having said that, qu'il me soit permis de dire quelques mots en français, comme nous avons parmi vous quelques communautés francophones, et nous devons également respecter la tradition bilingue de ce pays. Comme vous savez, ce référendum qui a été conduit au Soudan était observé par la communauté internationale et ils étaient tout le monde satisfaits qu'on croit qu'il s'agissait d'un référendum crédible et transparent. Et donc, le 9 juillet prochain 2020,